Hello, hello, my beautiful friends, and it is time to look at the astrology for this new moon coming Wednesday, November 7th at 15 degrees of Scorpio. We see that new moon aspect up here with the sun and the moon just up there together, holding hands in conjunction. So this is going to be a nice time of refreshment, right? We're going to begin a new cycle happening here, and we're going to begin it in the energy of Scorpio, which means we are going to purge. So before we jump into all of the new moon information, the Astrology 102 video course is now available for pre-order. Of course, the astrology video for 101 is out and available. Feel free to click in the description box and you can learn astrology right in the comfort of your own house, get your own foundational knowledge going, all of that good stuff. But 102 is available right now on pre-order and will be ready in about 2 weeks. So click in the description box down below, take advantage of all that good stuff, okay? All right, first and foremost, what is a new moon even about? At the new moon, we're going to plant our seeds of intention, right? Because the new moon represents the end of one cycle, we're going to begin another one. Right? So we're going to start something fresh. We've got another 28 days underneath our belt. And as we see, we've got the sun and the moon conjunction. So holding hands right there, sharing energy together. And when the sun and the moon come together, you guys, anything is possible. It is the ultimate energy of, okay, we can start, we can begin, anything can happen here. So this is the time, and I get asked this quite a bit, when is the best time to start something new? At the new moon. This is a wonderful energy. You've got 4 weeks of new initiative to start a project, launch a business, begin a new relationship, whatever it is, to have 4 weeks to use this going forward. Not to mention, because we are going to be in the sign of Scorpio, I think that this is a wonderful new moon for shedding things, letting go of old beliefs, old behaviors, old habits, old issues, old whatever it is, so that you can move forward fresh. Now, the effects from this particular new moon, like I said, we're going to have for 4 weeks. So look all the way, think about from coming from November 7th all the way until December 7th. So you've got a really nice chunk of energy to work with, okay? Now let's talk about the astrology that we see here. Where is my handy dandy little pen? This is just the best thing ever since I've discovered it, you guys. Okay. Let me move this guy out of the way. All right. So, like I said, first and foremost, we see that we have got the sun and the moon right here. They are in conjunction. That's what makes a new moon. Okay. Now, in the energy of Scorpio, let's remember a couple things. When we're thinking about where planets are comfortable, we know that the moon is not necessarily comfortable in the sign of Scorpio because it gets so deep, right? Scorpio is so deep. It's getting to the bottom of things because Scorpio energy is here to purge. We're going to get to the truth. We're going to see it for what it is. There's no lighter, softer, easier in the energy of Scorpio. So it's very intense for the moon to be over here, okay? So this is not the moon's most natural, comfortable position, but with the moon shining this nice, beautiful, illuminated light at this particular energy along with the sun, what we do get to see in the energy of Scorpio is what is sitting down there below. What's at the root of some things that have been going on for you? Now, this could be, of course, related to all childhood, your whole life, all of that good stuff. But I would really ask you to think, in the last 28 days, what have you become abundantly aware of that you need to deal with, you need to make some decisions on, or you need to, things are climbing to the surface a little bit, right? And it doesn't have to be anything negative or scary, you guys. It doesn't have to be anything like that. What are the things that you want? What are the things that you desire? Remember, Scorpio is power and control and determination and drive. What are you wanting to move towards? Maybe you've got this awareness like I do on this side of, oh my gosh, this is the thing that I want. I am in focused mode to move towards it. So what's coming up to the surface for you from this Scorpio energy that's trying to be purged and trying to be freed so that you can start something new with it, right? What is that energy for you? Now, in addition to seeing that we've got that beautiful new moon energy, we've also got some other aspects that we see going on here. First of all, we've got a really supportive aspect going on of the new moon being in trine and sextile to both Neptune and Pluto. So let's talk about these one by one so that I can point them out to you, okay? First and foremost, let's take this new moon being in a sextile. So we'll have this energy. Hopefully you guys can see me. You're following me. Whoop, it's whooping around here to Pluto. So there we go. Kind of looks like a squirrely French fry. Okay, so we've got that energy happening right there. Now, when the planets have sex, that's good for us, right? A sextile is a nice energy to work with because a sextile, unlike a trine, means you are going to have not only a pocket of opportunity or advancement available to you, but in a sextile, you're usually intelligently going to move with that energy. You're going to move towards it. You're going to do something with it. Unlike a trine, sometimes you don't do anything because there's too much ease. So with the moon, a new moon at that, in a sextile to Pluto, you are going to want to move forward. Right now, this is a sextile is not the aspect to just blow everything out of the water. It's not intense, but you're going to have a desire or feel a little bit more determined to move something forward. You realize this is my chance. Something in me has got to die off, or something about the situation's got to die off so that I can move it forward. Right? This is what you're going to want to do. Not to mention, because Pluto is over here in Capricorn, this could very much so have something to do with your desire to move your life purpose forward, your business, your structure forward in some way, shape, or form. Now, on the other side of that, we've got this beautiful new moon here working a trine over here to Neptune, okay? This is the aspect that we're working with right in here. So hopefully you're able to see that and identify that. Okay, the new moon in a trine to Neptune. First of all, remember, Neptune's a very idealistic energy. So you have an ideal set in your mind, in your head of where you're trying to go. You have the vision of it, right? Because remember, Neptune is still retrograde at this point. So you've been stirring this vision, your ideal, your fantasy. What do you want over here? You've been creating it in the ethers, in the visionary space, in the compassionate, creative space. And now you're getting an opportunity to start to move that vision forward, right? So not only are you going to, one, probably have this this feeling like you want to help other people, or you want to give, or you want to fill your purpose, or you want to have a wider effect on people around you, right? You may be feeling called to be a healer or to have a healing or something like that. With this new moon here, you get help setting the goals on how to make that vision concrete reality. And remember, at the end of November, we've got Neptune coming out of retrograde. So take those steps right now. What do you got to do to actualize the vision? What do you got to do to make the vision turn into the achievement and success in the concrete? Now, I do think because the moon has so much to do with relationships and Neptune is very compassionate and sensitive, we've had Venus retrograde for just a hot minute here, right? Now, I do think that the relationships in our lives actually get some compassion, some sensitivity, maybe even there's some forgiveness or there's transition in relationships. It's a very tender energy. So whether it's forgiveness of self, forgiveness of the past, because remember, this new moon is still in Scorpio. So it may be saying to you, in order to start this new business, in order to start this new life, in order to move forward and continue the determination you've got on the table, we've got to let these things in the past go. We've got to set them down, or we've got to move, you know, from the space of where we are now into maybe our uncomfort zone, right? So it's a really nice energy, I think, though. But I do think that relationships get a nice little benefit from it. Now, when you have the moon in any kind of combined energy, with Neptune and Pluto, especially because the aspects are a trine and a sextile, which are really soft or helpful aspects, I think that this is also a place where it makes it easy for you to purge, right? It makes it easier for you to let go of the shame, let go of the guilt, let go of the sadness, let go of the past, put it down, right? You're exactly where you're supposed to be right now. There is no more perfect situation than what you've got going on, even if it feels terrible. The moment you acknowledge that, you can take the next right move forward into a situation you feel like you'd like to be experiencing that's maybe different. So it's a very nice energy that we've got going here. Now, we do have a couple other things that I just want to point out really quickly, okay? First of all, we have got Venus, who is sitting very happily, might I point out to you, over here in a trine to Mars. Now, Venus trine Mars at this particular moon, this is a social energy. Okay, so I think that, again, this is an energy where it shows that you are genuinely interested in other people. You are genuinely interested in some level of socialness or companionship coming into your life, which is great, because if you're moving into a position where you're trying to find your purpose in the world, I can guarantee you that your purpose in some way, shape, or form involves contact, support, companionship, and conversation with others. Okay, so this is a great energy for getting you into some help with other people. This is getting you into social connection with other people as well. So I think that this is going to be an absolutely interesting new moon. It's phenomenal because it's a new moon for setting those seeds of intention. Plant them, set those goals. You may have to set some stuff down from the past. You may have to purge a little. You may have to put some forgiveness on yourself. You may have to acknowledge, you guys, that maybe what you have is a fear of success. That's a real thing. And whatever it is, you're going to spend this new moon seeing what's holding you back, but I think very willingly being willing to transform that so you can get ready to bring that vision you've been having into reality over this next 4 weeks. So I am sending you a lot of light, a lot of love. If you've got questions about where this moon or the other moons that we've got going for the rest of the year or moving into 2019 are happening in your chart, just let me know. You can find me at stormygrace.com. Click in the description box down below. Don't forget Astrology 101, 102. Those video courses are now ready, so you do not have to wait for a session to open to start learning and getting the foundations of astrology under your belt, okay? Like this video, comment, share, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.